What's going on, y'all? Machiavelli Mills TV, man. I'm here with baby Machiavelli, man. He's sitting on my lap chilling with me for the day. And the other day I was on Facebook, right? And I saw this topic that was very interesting to me. It was an article. I didn't even read the article, but I saw the headline and it made me think. And it made me want to have a discussion. Is remote learning causing a mental health crisis amongst teens and children? Now, I myself can't speak on the behalf of teens, but I can speak from the point of view of children. Me, I have two children. I have my three-month-old son, and I have a nine-year-old daughter. She'll be 10 coming up very soon, right? So I've been seeing her going through the virtual learning process, and I promise y'all, I can't wait until COVID is done and over with, and kids can go back to school. Because I've noticed a difference in her learning abilities and her even engagement in class since the remote learning has started, right? She often expresses that she can't wait to get back to the classroom for several different reasons. One, kids like being amongst their friends and they like being amongst their peers. But for two, I've noticed a lot of kids learn better when they're sitting in the class, in a classroom, in a class setting, and they have all the resources available handy in front of them with no distractions around them, right? Since the remote learning has started, I've talked to my friends who are my age, who have kids close to my daughter's age and younger, and they've expressed the same type of sentiments that I've expressed, right? Sometimes when this software is the remote learning software is lagging so much that it lags a lot, and sometimes kids can't get the proper learning that they need because it's glitching and so on and so forth, so they're not getting the lesson as much as they should. They're missing key components of the lesson, and they're left like wondering what's going on. They're missing steps, and they don't know how to carry out some of the tasks that need to be carried out in either math, science, art, so on and so forth, right? I've witnessed my daughter several times, like, crying because, like, she can't, sometimes it's lagging so much that she can't get help at the times that she needs help, and they have to move forward quickly, right? There are times when they have to copy and write down things, and she feels like things are going way too fast for her, right? Like, they're skipping ahead on notes way too fast. She doesn't have enough time to write things down, enough time to grasp things, right? And I'm not blaming it on the teachers because the teachers have their hands full. I think the teachers should be paid twice as much as they're paid currently, especially during these times. They have to help kids individually as best as possible. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they have to have one-on-one time during class. Hey, what do you need help with? What do you need help with? And it's taxing on them. They can't really do it. They can't do it all by themselves, right? Which results in parents who work, like myself and my other friends, having to really take our time away from work to be able to really go through the lesson with our kids while we're working. You know what I mean? So that's why I have a new profound respect for teachers. I've been had a profound respect for educators because I knew what they had to deal with and so on and so forth, but they really should be saluted, right? But this virtual learning is stressing a lot of kids out. I've heard stories from my friends where their kids were excellent students when they were in the classroom. As soon as virtual learning began, it's like things just took a deep plummet, a dive, right? And again, it's stressed out from the fact that sometimes they feel like they have way too many assignments at a time because they're trying to catch up to things in advance, advance extremely fast, you know what I mean, without really grasping it. It's hard for kids. Look, I remember me. I was a college student, right? And I didn't want online classes a lot because I felt like I learned best in a classroom setting. So can you imagine a second and third grader learning online virtually? They got their gadgets all around them, TV, phone. I mean, they just got out of their bed. It's like, it's hard for them to really focus and maintain their focus throughout an entire lesson, right? Again, so you have kids that feel like everything is just moving way too fast in a short period of time, and they don't have enough time to grasp the information because, for one, the teacher can't just keep helping them individually. They have to help other kids. It's really sometimes it's the time for tutoring and stuff and one-on-one sessions is really cut out. You know what I mean? So it takes a toll on these kids. It's taking a big toll on these babies without question, man. And I'm looking like, man, I can imagine being in third grade. I can't imagine that. Being in third grade, having to learn all through the computer, having to get your lesson plan just like sitting in front of a screen, just listening to your teacher talk when sometimes it gets choppy. Some kids don't have the best internet connection, so on and so forth. It's like some kids have their other brothers and sisters at home learning, sitting around them where they can't even focus. My child doesn't have that problem. But I've heard about kids really struggling, you know what I mean, because they have other brothers and sisters are around them, all virtual learning. It's hard for them to hear, hard for them to really gather the information as best as possible. And they just stressed out beyond measure, beyond their minds. They're little kids, man. And I think their learning environment needs to be cultivated in a certain way, right? It can't, like, learning out of your home sometimes is kind of like working out of the home. Of course, I'm remote working right now, but I love sometimes just going in for work, getting out of the house, not making where I live, where I sleep, my workplace. You know what I mean? Just getting a time to get fresh air, go outside and go into a different environment and learn. And the kids need that as well, man. And I'm promising y'all, I've been noticing it, man. It sounds like, again, my daughter's been crying because she feels like, man, everything is moving too fast. I can't really get my question answered right then when I need it. You know, it's like, it's just a lot of factors that's going into it, man. And it's like, she feels that she gets a better hands-on experience learning in the classroom because there's a teacher, there's a teacher's aide helping out, you know what I mean? So she can get certain concepts, well, you know, she can get pulled to the side and get explained these certain concepts. Right now, the teachers don't really have a lot of time to do that. They're trying their best, but they have so many kids to tend to, it doesn't really work out for them sometimes, man. And it's like, man, it really sucks that COVID has this set up with the remote learning going on. But kids are becoming stressed. They're becoming overwhelmed. It's been times where, you know, I found my daughter even stressed outside of the classroom hours because she's wondering, man, am I ever going to get this new lesson that we're learning in math? And she tells me things were so much easier in the classroom, right? So you got to listen to your children, too. They don't just, sometimes we think our kids are just talking outside of their head and they don't know what they're talking about. But she like, man, I learned so much easier in class, and which she did. I remember her grasping things right away in classroom setting, but when I'm with home, it's different. And I have to take time from my work day to come sit down with her and explain certain things when I have to do assignments, or even after I'm done, have to explain certain things in-depthly and try to give her my own kind of lesson plan with her learning so she can kind of grasp it better. And our teacher is doing a great job. I'm not saying the teacher isn't doing the best that she can. She is. But it's just like, it's their environment. Look at all the distractions. They go on a break. You know what I mean? It's like so much distractions around them. At school, it's no distractions. It's all schoolwork. They have their friends around them, of course, to eat lunch and all that and go to PE and all that type of stuff. They go to physical education or gym or whatever you want to call it. But then they're right back in the classroom. Here is like, it's so many distractions around them. Their bedroom is like, what, 5-6 steps away? It's kind of hard for them to really gather the information as best as possible, man. And it's like, some kids are even just being stressed out from the fact that they can't see their friends. They can't see their friend. They talk to them on a little virtual chat, but it's like they only can talk to them briefly. You know what I mean? Because they all have work to focus on outside of class hours. And during classroom time, the teacher might allow them to talk for a little quick second and do interactive things together, but it's not the same as being there face-to-face with your friends. And then it's like, you know, that the time talking is limited. You know, so I took my daughter to a birthday party to see her friend, and she hugged her friend so tight. She hadn't seen her friend in so long that it's like, man, it's telling you, man, it switched up the game. And I know, again, me as a college student, I didn't want to do no damn virtual learning. I didn't want to do none of that remote learning. I mean, online classes at all, because I knew that my attention span and my interest in a subject was much more vigorous when I was like in front of a teacher. For whatever reason, I like that interactive. I like the face-to-face interaction with the teacher, and I like the classroom interaction. It just breeds a different type of learning for myself. And I can imagine that for a child, right? That learning environment, that classroom learning environment is essential, man. And it's cultivated perfectly for the kids to really grasp certain concepts and certain things. Even the way they break, and when kids are learning math and it's broken down with certain things and you're using blocks and all that type of stuff, it's kind of like, it makes things so much better when teacher explaining things in a different way. And I'm not qualified to do a lesson plan for kids. I understand things, but just because you understand things does not mean you know how to get a kid to understand things the best way possible. That's what a teacher does. A teacher, they're qualified to do that. They're taught how to get a child to understand a lesson so that they can understand it to the best of their abilities, master it, and move forward. So, yeah, man, it's taxing on a lot of my friends. And I've heard some of my friends' kids or kids people I went to school with, their kids have been in trouble, danger of grades falling beneath satisfactory standards. And they had to, like, just try to hurry up and just try to sometimes even tell their kids the answers just so they won't be at risk of failing. tell their kids the answer so they can move forward and just get a good grade or a decent grade so they can just keep forward in the new quarter. You know what I mean? And that's just putting stress on just not only the child, but the parent. And even times, the parent is so stressed out after just working from home and trying to balance the two, that it's like they kind of stressing out their kids, hollering and yelling at the kid because they just so tired and exhausted from trying to be mother, father, and teacher all at the same time. It is crazy. And of course, as parents, we are educators within our home. We're supposed to teach our kids and help to back up the teacher's lesson plan. But again, it's totally different when you're in it, when your child is in the classroom with the teacher and when they're at home learning on the internet, man. It's like some of the software is behind. It's not the resources. Some schools don't have the best resources, unfortunately, right? My child's school has great resources, but even then her laptop has been lagging. She's been not able to hear certain things. It's been to the point where it's like, she's like, man, I really just want to understand this as best as possible. And it took her a nice amount of time, and it took me many times stepping away from my work activities to try to explain certain things to her so that she can get it as best as possible, because I've been watching her get frustrated from, like, oh my God, like, she thinking that we're moving too fast. Some other kids may be grasping things more than me, but the other kids, some of them, they're not either. They just don't, they're afraid to voice their opinion that they're not getting it. You know what I mean? And it's like, it's very difficult. It's very difficult, man. And I can imagine the teenagers, man, like in a world where everybody want to go to prom and all of that. And it's like, you can't even go to prom and celebrate, and kids can't even have graduations like we had and celebrate their academic achievements. So, man, I believe it's causing a mental health crisis. Kids are just being overly stressed. Some kids causing anxiety. I've witnessed kids, even in my child's classroom, I've listened and just kind of sat with her and seen kids just show bouts of anxiety. Like, man, I don't know how to do this. I'm afraid that I'm not going to pass, you know, the next test if I'm not grasping the concepts as best as possible. I've seen other parents get on there and express, like, hey, can we have a meeting time outside? And the teacher is trying as best as possible, try to get things going and moving forward. And the teachers are being overworked as well, because they're oftentimes working way beyond their hours to try to meet individually with every parent, because it's like a lot of these kids are struggling with it, man. They are kids, man. They're kids. So they're easily distracted. Their environment is like, it's just something that's completely new for them, even though it started way back in March. But it's just like, man, that was just the March to June was like a test run for real. This is the real deal for real. The whole year is virtual learning and how these kids will adapt. And it's not easy to adapt to a major change like this, man. But I'm really been praying for these babies, man. And I'm trying to just helping my daughter as best as possible, trying to make some things fun for her, and trying to make things as digestible as possible with these learning, with these lesson plans, and trying to break it down as best as possible, man. I promise y'all, boy, Mac been a teacher, y'all. Mac been a little teacher at the house trying to figure out a way to get my daughter how to understand things. I'm calling my sister. Me and my sister, we on there trying to, my sister like, okay, auntie gonna explain it. My sister on the phone telling my daughter, auntie gonna explain it like this. She trying to break down all different type of ways to explain certain things. And my mother as well, man. So yeah, man, I can imagine how these kids are feeling. Just being coming, just stressed out beyond measure. It's not funny though, but I kind of chuckled because I remember my daughter just saying, man, when are we going to go back to the classroom? I'm ready to go back in the classroom. I'm ready for things to just go back to normal. And I'm looking like, I understand. I'm ready for it to go back to normal too. So I hope COVID ends. I hope this stuff is over with soon and we all can just go back to our regular lives, because it's not just taking a toll on the adults with working and financial responsibilities changing due to people. Like, you know, people have lost their jobs due to COVID and all that type of stuff, right? And had to make adjustments. But the kids have had to make adjustments too. And we can't just let that slip under the radar and let that just go unacknowledged or unnoticed, man. They're going through a major change. They're trying as best as possible to try to get things done. Look at my son. He about to start crying and whining. Come on, boy. We almost through, man. But yeah, man, these babies, man, my heart goes out to these babies as they're trying their best. They're getting all these assignments to try to do and just to move forward in a lesson plan, and they're not even getting the information. They're not understanding what's going on, and they have these assignments to complete, which leaves parents like me and my friends and my other classmates having to work overtime outside of our hours to just break down the information to make sure our kids understand what they're learning, and then they can get to the homework assignment, man. Some parents, again, some parents are doing the homework for their kids so their kids won't fail, man. These kids are under a tremendous amount of stress, man. I can't wait for COVID to be over. Virtual learning is tough, y'all. Peace.